Hey everyone, I'm Mike from Regala Photography, where we talk about everything photography. In today's video, we'll be talking about photo editing software and whether or not you really do need to pay for them. There are many options out there for photo editing software, from free to premium options. However, the premium options can often come with a hefty price tag, leaving many people wondering, is it really worth it to invest in the software? First, let's talk about a couple free options. There are a number of free photo editing software options available, such as GIMP and PixelArt. These options can be great for basic editing, but they may not have all of the features that a professional photographer might need. All right, let's talk about the premium options. Adobe Photoshop and Lightroom are two of the most popular premium photo editing software options out there. While they do come with a cost, they offer a wide range of advanced features and tools that can take your photography to a whole new level. Adobe is the standard that all other editing software programs are compared to. Their new masking options are absolutely phenomenal in both Lightroom and Photoshop, or Camera Raw too. So, do you really need to pay for photo editing software? Well, the answer depends on your needs and goals as a photographer. If you're just starting out or you're just a hobbyist, a free option may be good enough. They offer plenty of options just to edit a basic photo. However, if you're a professional photographer or looking to take your photography to the next level, investing in a premium option may be worth it for you. But before you make any decisions, consider the alternatives. There are a number of subscription-based options, such as Adobe Creative Cloud, that can offer you access to multiple software options at a more affordable price. However, you do pay for it monthly, but you do get more than one app. So Adobe's photo plan, photographer plan, you get Photoshop and Lightroom together. So it might be worth it to pay for the monthly subscription and then get all updates continuously. There are also pay once options on the market that are very good for someone who doesn't want a subscription, but is okay with not getting all the latest updates every month or every year. Affinity Photo is very popular. It's a very popular Photoshop clone that offers a lot of what Photoshop has. Also, Luminar Neo has really moved up the ladder as a popular photo editing tool. Luminar has a lot of AI features that work pretty good, and a lot of people like them. However, they do nickel and dime you if you want some of the extra extensions that they offer. Capture One has been around for a long time and is used by a lot of professional photographers worldwide. However, it is quite expensive up front. If you want the latest updates, you'll have to pay yearly for them, and you have to pay the full cost. A lot of photographers, what they'll do is they'll buy it outright, they'll use it for a couple years, and then they'll upgrade again. So they're not upgrading every year. What if you're not a professional photographer who wants to do basic edits on your photos? Well, there are some apps that you probably already have. Apple Photos and Google Photos are some really good basic photo editors that come with your respective devices. If you're on a Mac, Apple Photos does quite a bit. Again, not as good as some of the paid software, but still very good. If you're editing on a phone or an iPad, Snapseed is very good and has a lot of great useful features that work very well. In addition, there are many online resources and tutorials that can help you learn how to use photo editing software effectively, regardless of whether you choose a free or a premium option. I have several videos on Lightroom and Photoshop right here on my channel. In the description, I'll link a couple other channels that I like very good that have awesome tutorials on Photoshop and Lightroom, which is the main software that I use. Photo editing software can be an important tool for photographers, but whether or not you need to pay for it really depends on your individual needs and goals. Consider all your options. Do your research before making any decisions. If you found this video helpful, please click the like button. Subscribe to my channel for more photography content. Ring that bell so you can be notified when my next video is posted. Until next time, take care, everyone.